what levels are we watching in the market right now? Are we about to turn lower or just keep breaking higher? This is Corey Rosenblum, and you're watching the Theo Nightly video for February the 5th, 2019. That's a question on everybody's mind as we push into our 2731 Dawn Gravity Spot, which is just shy of the 200-day simple moving average and the 2750 point in the S&P futures. These rectangle boxes are considered gravity spots or rectangle ranges, value areas, consolidation, take your pick of the term, but it's an area of decision. And that's where the bulls and bears have came together to balance, and we have equilibrium. And like a magnet, that's how we see these things, the price departed from it and got pulled right back into it. So that's a thought process on the bigger picture. But right now, with the market at the middle of these magnet spots, roughly 2750, we're at a key decision point. And really, what happens next this week and early into next week should give us big clues about how we position, how we adjust or readjust, and how we manage risk. So we'll just talk about these departure plays and these levels. So we're not necessarily making a directional bet here, but just noting specifically how important these 2731, 2750, and of course our other gravity markers in the S&P 500. So again, this market has departed from these rectangle ranges and been pulled back, departed down, and then been pulled right back. So we're going to have this thought process or dominant thesis, logic, if you will, that the market will pause, pull right on back, 2700, 2682, maybe even down to 2626. And these are key spots to look for a pullback. We'll go ahead and, if you will, call that the dominant thesis. If not, and if the market breaks just a little bit higher, we can easily see 2750 on an intraday basis or 2745. But I think if we get above 2750, we'll see another rapid short squeeze taking us to 2800. That's a round number, or Dawn's upper gravity spot at 2811. So these are future spots to be watching as we push into February. On the S&P, we'll take one little glance at our probability of expiring chart. This takes into account the true big picture of the market and the index and the ES futures. This again is our option volatility grid, and it takes into account our implied volatility and the price structure going forward. So these are up and down price levels for each of these future expiration cycles. And just put on the chart, it's our probability of expiring into a cone. And this yellow line is our 68% or one standard deviation. And the white line, two standard deviations, or roughly 95% of the expected move. So it just gives us a guideline for what to expect, or at least what the option market expects the volatility to be and the price level range to be in the future. So going out into March, we still have these yellow bands inside our gravity levels, our spots, our markers. So we do expect the market to chop around between these pivots. That means our current marker has us bearish or defensive or putting on risks into this 2750 area. Again, we're expecting chop, consolidation, maybe a little bit to 2800, but ultimately not a straight up rally, but also not a straight down turn. Just muddle through, middle of the road, chop. And we get that thought process from the earlier part in 2018 and the latter part of 2018. That's the S&P futures. We'll take a quick look now at the Nasdaq. We don't have those gravity spots in the Nasdaq, but we do have our similar chop or sideways rectangle boxes. We like to think of these as midpoint magnets, where the darker band is, and the upper spot is a resistance barrier and a support barrier. That's how we look at trading ranges. So the bulk of 2018, the Nasdaq formed a triangle or a progressively compressing trendline pattern. That gave way to a big breakdown. In 2019, we're seeing the reaction back inside the range. So again, this is global perspective or ways to think about price level from movement from a spot to marker or level, or in this case, box, gravity spot, etc. What are the Nasdaq levels in the future? So we're looking at roughly 7250 on the upside potential play, and maybe to the downside, roughly 6,600. Not that far away. But those are the markers as we pull this forward. And you can do this on your own charts. Take a look at gravity spots or take a look at midpoint boxes and just pull them forward. So as the market interacts, maybe we push a little bit above it, but ultimately get pulled back through it. And that's going to give us swing trades, short-term trades, option plays, and of course, how we direct or bias our intraday positions. If the market gets above and starts to fail and go back lower, that's going to lead to a series of bearish intraday positions, maybe even some trend days. The Dow has its rectangle spot. I'll go ahead and update this for us. And what is a rectangle spot? It's just looking at where the price has chopped, consolidated, and we can even pull this forward throughout the bulk of 2018 and even pull that forward further into 2019. So again, as the price gets above the rectangle spot, it is pulled back like a magnet. It overshoots the magnet to the downside, pulled right back into it to the upside. This is just pure price study or a pure price method with volatility added into the mix. So what's the thought process here? Identical. Maybe we see the Dow push up to this 26,000 range at the high, not that far away at the moment. Maybe we see a low down to about 24,000. We can see that into March. But as we push through February, look for these to be our boundaries. 26 at the top, 24 at the bottom, and roughly 25 as that midpoint. And it's not going to give us that much help in terms of longer-term plays. This is more of a short-term way to look at the markets. A lot of earnings are behind us. Some are still to come. We had Disney today, and Disney is spiking up. Google, despite maybe a lackluster performance, also was up a little bit on the day. Apple is strong, so we're getting a little bit of different performances in the equities themselves, but we're looking here at this perspective on the indexes. And that's where we're going to start and finish our video. So our Russell also has these probability grids, but it also has its rectangle range at roughly the same levels. So again, roughly 1,500 and about 1,550. Pull that forward. And here we go into February and March. Same logic. Maybe we see a chop to about the 1550 range, or maybe down to the session lows at about 1470 or 1465. However, as we go into this week and next, and maybe even through the month of February, monitor your price as it maintains itself inside these rectangles, gravity spots, highs and lows, or just consolidation zones. They are magnets, and they help give us a potential future for our intraday swing trades and any option sells or buys that we may put on. So each earnings, each stock, each movement, and each position that we take, keep it within this larger context of gravitational forces, really at the midpoint of the 2018 high and the 2018 low. That's roughly where we are. This is Corey Rosenblum with our Theo Nightly video for February the 5th, 2019. Take care.